Hi students, welcome to Justin NCRT Solutions. In this video, we are going to see 7th Standard Maths Chapter 3 Data Handling. The meaning of data is information. We are going to study how to handle the information in this chapter. And these are all the subtopics we are going to see in this chapter. Tally marks, range, mean, median, mode, bar graph, probability. Now we are going to see the first topic, tally marks. The meaning of tally marks. And here we have taken maths marks out of 10 students maths marks. Now we are going to write it in tally marks. First one marks they have scored. Next one tally marks. And the last place number of students and this is can be called as frequency or number of students. Now we are going to write it in tabular column. We will start from the small mark. The lowest mark is 3. Totally 2 members got that mark, so 1, 2. The meaning of this 2 means 2 bar we have written 2 line, that is equal to 2. Next, total numbers 1, 2, count is 2. Next mark is 4. In 4 only 1 mark, 1 member got that mark, so 1. And next mark is 7. In 7 totally 1, 2, 3. 3 members got 7 marks, 1, 2, 3. So 3 we have written. And next 8 mark is there. In 8, 1, 2 members got 8 marks, so 2. And next 9 mark. In 9 only 1 student. And in 10 marks 1. So this is the method to write tally marks in tabular column. In case totally 15 students are there, if we are taking that total out of 15 students, we will take 7 and here another one 8, here another one 9, another one 7 mark, then another one 10 mark, totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 students. Now we will check it. In 7, totally 1, 2, 3, 4 students are there. Totally 4 students are there. So we will add another 1. And next, 4, 5 students are there. Totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 students. After writing 4, we should not write like this another one line. We have to draw a line, diagonal line. The meaning of this 5. So now 5 students got 7 marks. And next 8. 1, 2, 3 members. So 8 marks, totally 3 members. We have written 3. Next 9 marks, 1, 2, 2 members got 9 marks. And next 10 marks, 1 and 2, 2 members got 10 marks. Now we can check that marks, total number of students and frequency. And total number of students should be equal. If you are adding 2 plus 1, 3, 8, 11, 13, 15. Totally 15 marks we have taken. Now total number of students is equal to 15. And if it is exceeding 5, we have to make like this line. Meaning of this 6. If you are adding another one line, that is 7, like that we can write. Next, we are going to see that range. the meaning of range. Range is equal to difference between the highest value to lowest value. Range is equal to difference between highest value. Highest mark or value minus lowest value. Here highest value is 10 minus lowest value is 3. So 10 minus 3. Range means highest value minus lowest value. Difference between highest mark and lowest mark. So here highest mark is 10, lowest mark is 3. So 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So range of the given data is 7. Next we are going to see mean. Mean, the meaning of mean is equal to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. We have to sum all the observations, then we have to divide it by total number of observations. We can take number 2, 3, 4, 5. Totally 4 observations we have taken. 1, 2, 3, 4 observations. Now we are going to find sum of all the observations. So 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Divided by totally 1, 2, 3, 4 observations are there. So we are going to divide it by 4 is equal to 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 5, 14 divided by 4. And now we are going to divide it by 4. In 14 we have 3 fours are 12, remaining 2 is there, we cannot divide it. So we are making decimal point. Now 20. In 20, 5 fours are 20. So mean of the given data is 3.5. The meaning of mean is equal to sum of all observations divided by number of observations. Here we have taken totally 4 observations. 2, 3, 4, 5. Sum of observation is equal to 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 equal to 14. Now 14 divided by 4 is equal to 3.5. Therefore, mean of the given data is mean is equal to 3.5. Next topic is median. Now we are going to check it. For these 5 observations, we are going to find median. The meaning of median is equal to mid value. Meaning of median is equal to mid value. Now we have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 observations. Out of 5 observations, we have to find the mid value. To find mid value, first we have to arrange this observation in ascending order or descending order. In any one order, we have to arrange it. First we are going to arrange it from the smallest value, 2. Next value, 3. Then 4, 5 and 6. Totally 5 observations we have arranged it in ascending order. Now mid value, 1, 2, 3. Mid value is 4. So median of the given data is equal to 4. And to find this value, there is a formula is there. To find median, if it is odd number of observation, if number of observations, is odd, we have to find this formula, n plus 1 divided by 2. If number of observations is odd, we have to use n by 2 divided by 2. If number of observations is even, if number of observation is even, formula is n by 2 and n plus 1 divided by 2. If the total number of observations is even number, two mid values will come, n by 2 and n plus 1 divided by 2. We can see it here itself. If we are having number 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 observations are there. So here mid value will be 4 and 5. 4 and 5 also median of the given data. Next we are going to check it mode. Mode of the given data. Here if you are taking numbers 4, 5, 6, 2, 4, 4. Here we have taken data's observations in this. The meaning of mode is equal to most number of times, which is coming the large number of time. We can check it here 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times this 4 occurs. This 4 occurs 4 times. 4 occurs 4 times. Next 6, 1, 2. 6 came only 2 times. Next 5, 1, 2. 5 also came 2 times. And remaining 2, 2 times. And 3 only 1 time. So in this, most of the time, totally 4 times 4 occurs. Therefore, mode of the given data is 4. Meaning of mode is most number of time, which is coming large number of times in that observations is called mode. Next we are going to check it bar graph. How to draw bar graph and types of bar graph. We have two types of bar graph. First one is single bar graph. Single bar graph. We will draw this bar graph in x-axis and y-axis. This horizontal line is called x-axis and this point is x, positive side. The negative side x dash. Then the vertical line is y axis and this is positive side and this is negative side is mentioned as y dash. X axis, y axis. Now we will write that required values in x axis and y axis also. Now we are going to draw a bar graph for subjects maths, science, social science. We will take only three subjects, math, science, social. Now this side we are going to take it for semester 1. Otherwise we can take it pen paper test 1, PPT 1 mark. In maths, totally out of 20, 18 marks. In science, 15 marks. Social science, 10 marks. Now we are going to draw. In x-axis we will take subjects maths, science, social science. Then in y-axis we are going to take marks 5, 10, 15, 20. Now we are going to draw it in this. Here maths mark is 18. So in the subject maths we will draw 18. 15 is here, then 16, 17, 18 will come in this place. So up to here ...18. Next in science 15 mark. 15 is here. 15. Next in social science only 10 marks. We have drawn like this. This is single bar graph. And if it is double bar graph, we are going to check it for double bar graph to compare two types of marks. For example, now double bar graph. Now we are going to compare. This is pen paper test 1, next one pen paper test 2. In second test, maths 20 out of 20, science 18, social science 15. This is second mark, but same person, same subjects. We are going to compare two marks, pen paper test 1, pen paper test 2. So now, nearby that single bar graph, we are going to draw another one bar graph to compare. So now, same subject maths, this time 20 out of 20. So from here, we are drawing. Now 20 out of 20. Next, to show the difference, we can make lines like this, or you can shade it. You can shade or some other difference you have to show. And next, this time, so in that science PPT 2 is 18 mark is there. So now we are drawing up with the 18. To show the difference, we are making cross lines. And next, social science, this time 15 mark. And to show the difference, we are making cross lines. So like this, we can use single bar graph or double bar graph to show the two types of data in one graph. Next, we are going to see the probability. Probability means probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes. And here we are going to see that probability for coin. What are the possible ways are there? Head and tail. And next, here total number of observation is equal to, total number of outcomes, only two outcomes is there. To get head as answer, we have only one possibility is there. Out of 2, we will get 1 divided by 2. Our favorable outcome is head. So out of 2 options, only one option will come, that is 1 divided by 2. To get head as answer. And if it is tail also same option is there. Only possible answers are 2, and out of 2 we can get only 1. So 1 by 2. And if it is dice, if we are throwing dice is equal to total possible answers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To get 4 is answer, total number of outcomes is equal to 6. Out of 6, how many possible answers are there to get 4? Only 1. So 1 by 6. So this is called probability. Probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by number of outcomes. Okay, that's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box. Share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.